Uma meets Minister Nankabira over electricity tariffs. Ugandan exports to Rwanda flourish. New car dealers double exports to East Africa. Air Rwanda to buy 250 Airbus planes. And the EU Parliament votes to ban petrol cars by 2035. A very good evening and thank you so much for joining us on The Business Show this week. My name is Simon. From where you're watching, we are glad you could make time. There's just so much happening in the world of business. And listen, so we are into what? The second week, coming to the third week of Feb 2023. I hope the goals that you set at the start of the year is probably what you're still counting on and keeping track. Sometimes we just get off track so very fast by the different challenges in the market. So I presume you are still onto the goal and hopefully you're doing the right thing, the different consultations. And if you ensure that you stick to what you start with, in most cases these things will just work out. Welcome to the show. Let's get the show started.
Focus on improving the quality of your product and services. Many Ugandans are now very, very conscious of quality. So the moment you invest your time in improving the quality of your products and services, you're going to attract more of your customers.
Once again, welcome to the show. Now, we'll start with the East African region. And this week, the conversation is on electricity and the operationalization of the Eastern African power pool way to trade power within the region. Now, we know for a fact that there are countries within the region that have more power than they can consume. At the start, I said the Minister of Mineral Development did meet UMA, the manufacturers in the country, and the conversation was about power tariffs, having the tariffs charged lowered to about 5 US cents. Now, this is only because the minister will tell you that there's more electricity here than the manufacturers can consume, which somehow then means that if we have, I would call it an excess, then maybe we can send it out to make some money. So maybe we sell some electricity to Kenya, yeah? And that is the debate that we are looking through today in Views from the Top as we speak to the acting MD of the Uganda Electricity Transmission Company Limited, who tells us how far they have gone with the plans to operationalize this, but also their plans to, actually there's a meeting that will be happening through this year to see just what else needs to be done before this can effectively be operationalized. Views from the Top.
Thank you very much. Talemwa Michael Kanonra is my name. I'm the Acting Chief Executive Officer of Uganda Electricity Transmission Company Limited. And by virtue of that position of the Chief Executive Officer, I am mandated to head as a chair of the steering committee of East African Power Pool. East African Power Pool is a body, corporate, that brings all the members within the East African region and beyond. It has members from Egypt, Liberia, Egypt, Libya, Sudan, South Sudan, Djibouti, Ethiopia, Uganda, Kenya, Tanzania, Rwanda, Burundi, DRC, Somalia, and those members came together to form a pool to come together to have the water resources and the energy resources shared. So the East African Power Pool helps to coordinate the interconnection between the among those member countries to help share the resources to do with electricity. Majorly, the objective is to do away with energy poverty. If I could give an example, you are looking at if the Renaissance Dam of Ethiopia, once completed, it will be able to provide electricity to Kenya. At the moment, Ethiopia has completed its transmission line that it's a 600 kV transmission line that moves from Ethiopia and goes to Kenya. And that line is able to supply power to Kenya. Now, it is cheaper to share the cost of the transmission line than to put up your own generation plant, because you may not have the resources that are necessary for putting up a generation plant. But so if your neighbor is having that kind of resource, then you benefit from that interconnectivity with one another. And the steering committee, we held the 28th steering committee meeting. The composition of the steering committee is the chief executives of those utilities from the member countries. So in Uganda, UETCL is a member, is a utility, and so the chief executives of those utilities were present here in Uganda. The occasion was also graced by 8 ministers. Previously, the trading was a discussion between the different member states. So if, for instance, Uganda and Kenya are to trade, then they would engage a legal consultant, then they would engage a financial analyst, then they would engage an engineer to come up with a framework or a power sales agreement to help in the in drafting the regulations that govern the relationship. And this, because of the limited funding, it was being funded through the development partners. So with the support of the World Bank and other development partners, the member states agreed to have a framework, a document that will prescribe the conditions for trading. And then once you are ready to trade, then you can sit with your member state that is interested, and then in this particular framework, you align this particular framework to specific contract that you want to enter into with your member country, and then you are specific on the trading. You are providing the terms, you are providing the line, the voltages, you are providing the rates that you are going to be charging, and all of that. So with the support of the World Bank and other development partners, we've already had that bilateral trading framework, which the members agreed in principle, but requested to first consult their approval procedures in their home countries before signing that framework. The framework is coming in to guide how the member countries will operate. But within the framework, there is that contract that would govern the relationship between these two parties who would want to trade. Now, under the EAPP, still with the support of the development partners, like the World Bank and African Development Bank, we are also at the final stages of agreeing on a framework or a tool that will govern the day ahead markets. Now, the day ahead markets is more or less like the way you go into stock exchange, and you find there are different companies with the share prices. So in this particular case, there will be different companies selling electricity but at different prices. So then you will be able to choose which country or which utility you would want to buy from. So that is going to help if, for example, Uganda is having cheaper power compared to Kenya. On that day, on that platform, what we are calling their head market, then if Rwanda is the one that is interested in buying, then it will deal directly with Kenya, and then will incur only the cost of wheeling. On how close we are to realizing the dream of the East African Power Pool. One is that, let me start with the day ahead market. The target for day ahead market is 2024. So we are left with literally about 10 months. So by January 2024, we expected that all member states will be working on that platform, and we shall have the countries declare their availability and how much they would be selling to the member countries. However, we believe that once the day ahead market is operationalized, then there will be motivation for even these other projects that are in the pipeline to be expedited, because that will be revenue that you are losing by you not being interconnected with your neighbors. For instance, if Uganda delays to complete the project for Uganda DRC, then we'll be losing money by the World Bank projects that we are losing. There is an opportunity cost that we are foregoing of about $8 billion that we are foregoing by not being interconnected to trade with one another. So once we are interconnected, one, we will have the region benefit as a region. Number two, you are having the customers, you are having the country being able to service its loans or service its debts that were acquired in putting up that infrastructure. So, for example, we have installed capacity of about 1,400 megawatts. But then you find that at peak demand, you are talking about 850 megawatts. So if we had that demand, if we are not constrained with the demand, then we would be able to generate, to use the plants up to maybe 1,000 megawatts. And so we believe that once we have that interconnectivity, then we will have demand. We are looking at opening up the different borders, and you are having different customers. So the benefit is to the government, first of all, in servicing the loans. It is to the customers, because once you have many people who are consuming power, certainly the cost of power will go down. The third thing is that the government the business community will also benefit in having stable and reliable power, since you are interconnected, so you will be having different sources of power supply.
So I guess if you have it in excess, then keeping it and not making any use of it doesn't help, yeah? So it's important that if we are sure that we have power that is enough for our industries and the general consumption, then it's important that all these grids that have been pushing in power, we just sell some power to, let's say, Kenya or Rwanda, and make some money. And it should be something that is quite lucrative, because look, the investments that go into these dams to the point where we actually have power running through is huge. So for us to imagine that we have excess power and be proud about it and just sit back doesn't make actual business sense. So we hope this works, and when the council sits through the year, we hope that the outcomes will be positive, and for countries like Uganda that have, you know, power in excess right now, maybe we could just start it off and see how we sell some power across the East African region, right? You're watching The Business Show with me, Simon. Feel free to get in touch with us in the meantime. Drop us those comments on our socials right below your screen. tell us what you think about the show. And listen, in case you want any particular topics handled, I mean, it's why we're here, to get you all the experts to tell you what you need to know about your business. Let's take a quick break. I'll see you shortly. Stay with us.